Hey there, magic geeks! Today I will explore a relatively new feature that is called Enhanced Conversions for Leads. I'm super excited, so let's dive into implementation. Not all conversions are made directly online. In some cases, people might go to your web page, submit a lead form, and then later go to the actual store and buy a product or get the services delivered. And it's called offline conversion tracking. An example could be purchasing a car or getting some beauty services. And you might know already the tracking method with the help of Google Click ID. And recently, Google introduced a new feature that is called Enhanced Conversions for Leads. And I don't say that the method with Click ID is not valid anymore. No, it's just a second way of tracking offline conversions. And I think it's pretty cool because you don't have to modify your lead form or CRM system to receive a Google Click ID, which means you can set up everything on your own without asking your developer for help. And it's nice. How does it work technically? A user clicks your ad, goes to your webpage, and submits a lead form. This is exactly where magic happens. We are sending user data to the ads account. Later, this user goes to your store and buys a product or a service. But how can system know that this is exactly this user? Because we have to upload the user data to the ads account, and then the user data is matched and the conversion can be recorded. So this is the technical overview. In order to implement this, we would need your web page with a lead form. You can see mine, and this is a demo shop built with WordPress. We would also need the tag manager, and please make sure that the tag manager is implemented on your web page, as well as Google Ads account. And the first step is to set up a conversion in the ads account. Let's go and click Tools and Settings, Measurement, Conversions, and we have to create a new conversion action. And let's click Import. Here are the data sources, and we want to track conversion from clicks. Let's click Continue. Here we have the settings, and we should select the goal category for this action. We have qualified lead and converted lead. So what's the difference? Qualified leads are so-called interested leads, and they help track Google-generated leads that have also been further qualified offline in your CRM. Whereas converted leads are the leads that have completed a chosen step in the lead conversion process. So this could be a closed deal or a sale. In my case, it's a sale because we are offering in-house training. This is why I select converted lead. Let's provide the conversion name. And you should provide all the settings here and click Create and Continue. And you can also select the import method. In my case, I want to use uploads. Let's click Finish. Well done. We have configured the conversion in the ads account. The second step is to set up a tag in Google Tag Manager. But before doing that, let's go to our web page and let's have a look at the form that we want to track. So for enhanced conversions, we should grab user data and specifically email or phone. Email is the preferred way, or you can grab both. How can we do that? There are multiple ways to do that. So you can go with CSS selectors or with a data layer variable or with the custom JavaScript variable. In my case, I'll go with CSS selectors. So what do we have to do? Let's fill in this form. And our task is to capture this user data. How can we do that? Let's click here, right click, and then inspect. And you can see this highlighted area. Let's right click one more time. Copy selector. In this way, we can capture this value. And we have to go to the tag manager and create a variable that would store this value. Let's click Variables. And here, user-defined variables, new variable configuration. And what kind of variable should we choose here? What do you think? Yeah, it should be DOM element because we are working with a CSS selector. And you should also select CSS selector here. And let's paste our selector. And you can see that this is a form and this is the input of the form, but we want to grab the value. This is why we should also specify an attribute name here, value. And let's provide a proper name. And let's save our variable. And we should do the same for the email. So let's go back. And what do we have to do? Exactly. Right click, copy, copy selector. Let's click new, variable configuration. You already know which variable type we should choose. And this is DOM element, CSS selector. Paste it here and value. And we should also provide a name. Let's save our variable. And now we can set up our tag. Let's go to tags and click new tag configuration. And I know it might be really tempting to select Google Ads conversion tracking, but for this conversion, we must scroll down and find something else. And it's called Google Ads user provided data event. And select this one. Here we should provide the conversion ID, but where can we find it? Let's go back to the ads account and here click tools and settings, setup, Google tag, click installation instructions and install manually. And this is exactly our Google tag. And we should look for this number here. And let's copy it without AW hyphen, just the number. And let's go back to Google Tag Manager and paste it here. And we should provide our user data, right? Email and phone. So let's click here, new variable. And here is our email. We already created a variable for that. And the same with the phone. And let's provide the name here as well. And let's save it. And we should also set up a trigger. Let's have a look at our form one more time. So this is form submit and it's located on the page with the contact us. So let's copy this part of the URL and let's go to triggering. And this is a form submission. And this is why I will choose the trigger type form submission. And I want to track not all forms, yet some forms. And I want to specify the condition page URL contains contact us. And let's provide the name and let's save it. And just a remark here. So this might be different for you. So these are the selector that I have and you can see something else and it might not always be the best solution. So in this case, you would have to ask a developer to adjust those variables or to provide other variables so that you can work with those. And the same with the trigger for the events. So sometimes it might not work, but it's kind of universal situation. And in most cases, it should be working. Okay, so this is my tag. Let's provide the name of the tag. And let's save it. And we are almost there. But we forgot to set up one super important thing, and it's called conversion linker. And it is fundamental to have this one because this is exactly the way the Google Ads click can be identified. And we are doing the implementation via the tag manager. And this is why it is extremely important to configure it. Let's click new, tag configuration. Here we have conversion linker and where should we fire it? Exactly, all pages. Let's save this one. Great, so now we are ready to test our implementation. Let's click preview. Great, and what do we have to do? Yeah, we have to fill in our form. So let's provide the phone number. Let's submit. Well done. And let's go to the tech assistant and let's see what happens here. So this was exactly my event number 8 form submit. And you can see tags fired. So this is a good sign. So it means it is working. And let's click variables. And here we go. This is my email, my phone. Everything is correct. And you can also see the user provided data. Yeah, it's an object and it contains email and phone number. If you see that, well done. You managed to configure everything correctly. So let's go back to the tag manager. And now we can publish our container. Let's click submit, publish. Awesome. So now we are sending user data to Google Ads. And let's say this user goes to your store and makes a conversion. What do we have to do? And this is exactly the last step of the whole setup. Yeah, we have to notify Google about it. So let's go to Google Ads account. And here, let's close this one. And let me close all those tabs because we don't need them anymore. Click Tools and Settings, Measurement, Conversions. And on the left side, we have Uploads. And here, you should go to Schedules. And we will schedule our new upload. And we are going to use a Google template. And this is a Google Sheet, so you can make a copy of it. I will share the link with you in the video description. Let's make a copy of this document. And this is exactly where you will provide your conversion data. So let's say my user converted, and now I can provide this data here. Once you provide your data, it is extremely important to hash it. You remember that you have to send hashed data and you should use the CHA256 encryption method. And this is a cool thing about this template because Google can actually do it for you. You can click extensions, app screen, and you should go to the left side and here you can configure a trigger. Let's add a new trigger and select event type. We should choose on change and let's click save. You will have to give some permissions here and click allow. Once your data is hashed, you can upload it to Google Ads. So you can go to Google Ads and here click plus, select source. In our case, it's Google Sheet. And we have to link an existing Google Sheet. So we would have to copy this account here and share the access by clicking share. Let's paste it here and click send. And in Google Ads, you should also select the frequency and it's recommended to have every 24 hours. Let's select the time and I forgot to link it here. And now you can save it. So you managed to configure your enhanced conversions for leads correctly. Well done. So you already know what enhanced conversions for leads are. And I'm really curious if you managed to implement this feature on your own. So please share your experience in the comment section below. And if you like this video, please give us a thumbs up and you can check other ads tracking videos right here. So happy measuring, guys, and see you next time.